Hello everyone and welcome to another video from GeoDota. Today I'm bringing you quite a special video. It's one I've been very excited about uploading. I played it a couple of days ago with my good friend Wyken, who is in this game. I've been playing with him for a long time now. We did some ranked games here and there. We don't play as much as we used to, but this is a ranked game actually that we recently did. So this is no sort of, this is not a normal pub game. I'm not queued with anyone of a lower ranking. He's actually a higher rank than me. So we're queued against people who should be of considerably similar skill level to ourselves. So this game, I'm going to warn you guys, this game has a fair few pauses. I'm going to do my best to, commentate and be as entertaining as possible during these pauses, but I can't guarantee that they'll be very fun to watch, so I will include annotations and links in the description for you of timestamps for you to be able to skip these pauses, because no one really wants to sit around. You don't want to waste your time, guys. This video is going to be long enough. It's a fairly long game. It's about 40-45 minutes, I think. So you don't want to be spending that time. You don't want to be spending that time sat watching a pause. So just go take a quick drink here. Sorry about that, guys. this video, I'm pretty excited to bring it to you. I don't want to spoil anything off the bat. Obviously, the title will reveal quite a lot of what happens in this game, but there are things that happen in the game that are really quite cool. Quite a few nice plays that I make with Meepo. Quite a few nice multi-kills. So I hope you guys really enjoy this. So do stay for the duration of the video. Obviously, there's a pause right now. This one will all be timestamped, so if you're still watching, I'm just gonna unlock from player perspective and just have a look around at what we're looking at here. So this was I believe it was all pick ranked. I tend to not do all pick ranked purely because I feel what the changes they've made, that you now get penalized if you wait to counter pick. It's not too bad, but I still think all pick ranked, it's a little bit sort of, people are gonna are free to just pick the most try hard lineups that they want without any sort of repercussions. I don't play as much as I used to, so I tend to just play more for fun now than actual climbing the rank system. All right. Anyway, I'm gonna put this back on play perspective just so you can see my mouse movements in the game. Unfortunately, I can't bring this to you as I'm playing it. I tend to not like how much fraps brings down my FPS while I'm actually playing, so unfortunately until I upgrade my system or find a workaround, most of the games, if not all of them, are going to be brought to you in a replay format like this. There's not much difference, and it is in fact easier for me to commentate, because playing Meepo and commentating, at least for me, is incredibly difficult to do right. The commentary won't be as interesting as you'd want it to be. But anyway, guys, like, if you haven't caught my most recent announcement video, I basically told you guys that I would be releasing this video and that I've improved my microphone quality. Hopefully the audio imbalance isn't that bad. If it is, I'm just gonna wipe this video and record it. But if this is the one that's made it, then it will be because the audio quality's fairly good. There you go, there's a very quick first blood. I'm going to keep this focused on me and what I was doing in the game to make it more of a realistic reflection of what it's actually like. You know, the fog, everything. What it's like to play Meepo with the reduced night vision and everything, rather than having free camera on and just scrolling around. So I am going to miss kills that happen that don't involve me or that I'm not that I wasn't looking at while I was playing it. So unfortunately there, I missed first blood, but I'm just going to keep it on this. If you guys want me to keep it on free camera, please do tell me. But for the purpose of this video, I'm going to keep it on player perspective. I hope you guys don't mind. I don't know what I'm doing here. Maybe I'm tabbed out or something. I was disconnecting. There we go. So this is another pause. I'm really sorry, guys. There are a few pauses in this game. But like I said, down in the description below, quick, accurate skips. You won't miss anything. Any gameplay, I'll make sure there are a couple of seconds either way, so you don't miss anything. You can just skip. I think this is where my power surged. Actually, I was streaming during this during this video. So I think when this comes back up, I take a while to reboot my stream. Unfortunately, not a lot of people watch me stream, but that's to be expected, you know. If you're not a big time streamer, you can't start at the top, you have to start at the bottom. So I think I had at this point about 2 or 3 people watching. If you are interested in watching me stream, guys, I will always include a link to my twitch.tv in every video that I put out, so do check that out if you like to see me play live, if you'd like to see how I actually do things on the spot. A lot of people think I use scripts and macros, and I'd really like to make it clear that I don't, and I wouldn't recommend that, because if you really want to play Meepo seriously, I feel you've got to do it the hard way. You can't afford to use these scripts and macros, whatever people say, these hacks. I don't know what people are getting at when they say that. Maybe, I don't know. I'm not going to say jealousy, because I don't think I'm that great. Maybe they think that some of the movements I make are a little bit suspicious, but like I've said in my previous Meepo videos, tab is basically how I do everything so quickly, because I use QWE and tab is right next to QWE, so it works out quite nicely. So you can tab poof really quickly. I'm just going to take this opportunity, because it's a pause, I expect quite a lot of you to just skip through this, so I'm just going to take this opportunity to take a quick drink. Sorry guys, I'm a little bit thirsty. It's quite interesting actually watching the replay back. When you're disconnected, you can actually see what happened in the game, even though you weren't there. Obviously you can see what they're saying about you, which is quite interesting. They seem to please come ghost me, yeah, talking about stream sniping me. I'm not really bothered about this whole stream sniping thing. I think it's on about like a 45 second, maybe a 1 minute delay, so there's not really much they can gain from that. I don't think there's not much you plan 45 seconds ahead. Maybe Roshan, I guess. But nothing really game breaking. I do apologize for the length of this pause, guys. If you just want to obviously watch through the pauses just to listen to what I'm saying, that's totally fine. There's not a whole lot I can say. I'll just unbind it again, go to free camera, see what we have here. Obviously we have an offlane clockwork. The only guy I was pre-made with in this game was Wyken. Sorry, I thought he was Invoker because his favorite hero is Invoker. I play with Wyken quite a lot. It's quite good. We're of pretty similar skill level, which is very nice. We're of pretty similar mindsets as to how the game works. We're on quite a level playing field there. We don't disagree on much in terms of what we want to do or where to take the game, which is nice. It's always good to have like-minded people to play with of similar skill. Quite lucky in that respect. But yeah, he's the only guy who's pre-made with in this game. So unlike my previous Meepo video where I got 39 kills, where I was part of a 5-stack, people picked around me, people babysat me. These guys obviously are trialing with me, but they later on in the game. Yeah, okay. Do ignore the chat, guys, if you're not interested in that. I do apologize if anyone's watching that's a bit younger. But it's what it is. You can't really escape it in Dota. But anyway, like I was saying, these guys are obviously not with me because he just called me. See you next Tuesday. But that's what it is. That's Dota. It's a very toxic environment. I try to ignore it and just enjoy the game and play with who I want to. I recommend that. But anyway, back to my point. I'm not pre-made with anyone apart from Magnus, who's Wyken, obviously said. I've known him for quite a while. So yeah, these guys try lane with me, but later on in the game, well, quite quickly on in the game actually, they abandoned me in this lane, which is fine for me. I really like to have a 1v1 lane. I've even gone against tri-lanes as Meepo, and people are like, oh, why would you do that? He's a very weak, he's melee, he has no base damage, he has no escape. Now that's not so true, because at level 3 you have an escape, you can poofed out to your second Meepo. Unless they have a lot of hard stuns, you're very survivable with that armor and magic resist. So I would definitely not be afraid to take Meepo in a 1v2 or 1v3 lane, as long as you're safe lane. I would not take him off lane, which is, if you're new to Dota, is this lane and this lane or off lane. So I think that I'm pausing. I think I get back into the game pretty soon. Obviously, you know, if you're pushed for time, you'll have skipped. If you've not, then thank you for sticking around. I really appreciate the interest. Obviously, you're interested enough to watch through this and listen to me babble on. I mean, quite a few minutes have already passed now. It's big chunks of this game are pauses, unfortunately. But like, if you were to watch the game live, you would have to sit through these pauses as well. If you were to watch it on stream, or just to watch it fraps, that's me playing it, you would have to sit through these pauses as well. So it's not too bad. They're calling me No-Tail. It's quite ironic that they are, like, sort of mocking me. And, like, even my own teammates are mocking me for being this streamer Meepo player. This is a very short pause, by the way. I will, again, link a annotation if you so desire to skip this pause. It's very short. But as I was saying, they were sort of mocking me. At the end of this game, I don't think they will be by the same opinion. And that's not me being arrogant, because my score is pretty nice. Like, they eat their words a bit in this game, I think, which I'm quite happy. Even though I don't really care what they think, I'm quite happy to make them eat their words in that respect. It, you know, it's, you can call it smug, but I find it funny. I just find it funny. Anyway. Back to the game, ignoring everything that's been said by them or whatever they think. I'm basically just laning 1v1. Obviously, my other two teammates here, they're rotating mid. They do quite a nice bit of rotating, but when I'm playing Meepo, I tend to tunnel vision quite hard, which a lot of people would see as a disadvantage, but it can be an advantage if you just sort of concentrate on yourself. Because obviously you're controlling quite a few heroes. If you just concentrate completely on yourself, obviously take into account what's happening elsewhere, but if you don't worry too much about what your teammates are doing, what they're doing wrong, what they're doing, you just play your own game and play and help them out, you're gonna do fairly well by it, actually. If you just treat yourself as sort of like a global presence, but always rank yourself at the top. You know, you need to be selfish and put yourself first in every respect when you're playing Meepo, I find. So I'm just playing this solo lane, playing my own little game, 1v1 in this Clockwork. Clockwork, a fairly strong hero, but he's nowhere near strong enough to push Meepo up the lane. His Clockwork player played okay. He could have played a lot better. He could have harassed me a hell of a lot more. I'm not sure what skill build he went for. What skill build did he go for? Okay, so he's going to max his rocket, I believe. Which is fine. There's lots of different ways you can skill Clockwork. I'm not that clued up on the hero. I like the hero, but I can't say that I'm really sort of, I know the different variations and skill builds you can do. I know that some people like to max cog, some people actually like to max battery assault. Obviously here he nearly gets a nice cage on me there, which would have been quite bad for me, actually, because my second Meepo was quite low. But this is the strength of the new Meepo. If you haven't been keeping up with Dota, guys, what the patches that were going in, or you've recently come back to the game, Meepo recently got a buff. In the previous patch, he sort of got a nerf. A lot of people thought it was a buff, but I think it was a nerf. But the 6.80, the one that's just come out now, I truly believe is a really nice buff. His ultimate has been rescaled down to level 3 now. It's 3, 10, and 17, I believe. Yeah, 3, 10, and 17. It's really nice, guys. I actually do take a fall here. I was relying on Shadow Demon to come and help me here, but unfortunately he was stacking a bit slow there. I do get rocket fled and died. So, you know, the start of this game doesn't look too great. I misplayed that pretty hard. I shouldn't have gone in. I wasn't expecting, you know, I got cogged into an enemy creep wave. There's not a whole lot you can do about that. opposed to like just not getting into that situation. So a fairly big misplay here. I mean, at the time I was sort of almost blaming Shadow Demon for not being there, but really that was on me. So I you know, looking on it now, that was on me. You know, the game doesn't get off to an amazing start, for me at least. My farm's okay. Obviously less testing with Meepo versus a clock is fairly difficult. He has a nice animation, obviously I just missed one there because I'm awful. But but Clockwork's animation is very similar to Meepo's, but he has a lot more base damage. So, you know, he's gonna have a lot easier time last hitting and denying me. But he doesn't really do that, which is probably like the biggest flaw for him in this lane. He lets me get too much, even though he did kill me. So yeah, very slow start, guys. Obviously I'm just, this is basically how most of my Meepo games start. They don't start off to this super amazing, like I get fed at 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes, I'm fed, I've got stacked camps. It's not like that. It tends to just take a very slow start. Like I've always said, guys, don't get too hung up, like I'm missing last hit sick, it's just awful, I'm so sorry. But like I've said, like don't get too hung up on not having enough farm. And you can see, like, I'm not doing very well last hit here. I mean, I have 28 CS, which is fairly nice. It's not bad. I could have about 32 or 3 here if I'd actually been playing properly and had and not missed last hits just due to just being a bit bad. But like I said, don't get too hung up on not having nice farm. He's not reliant on getting amazing farm right from the start. Other people will tell you otherwise, but I truly believe if you get the XP, you can accelerate your farm to such ludicrous degrees. I'm looking for a kill here on the Clockwork with the Shadow Demon. This is what I like to do, and I've started doing a lot more of. Like I said, I've been trying to improve my Meepo play. It's keeping a Meepo in another lane like this. It can be considered a little bit of a waste. It's sort of like an investment, if you like. You don't have them farming, you have them ready in another lane to gank. Usually I don't leave them there that long, but this is what I like to do if I'm pre-made with someone. I like to try and support them a little bit by having that Meepo there as backup if they're going to get dived. Which obviously you can see Clockwork has transitioned, but obviously I'm not looking there. I'm going to keep this on player perspective just for the purpose of this video. But yeah, like I've been saying, slow start, very slow start. I've even died, it's not been great. I've actually transitioned my second Meepo bottom here, which is really nice. They didn't actually expect that because they saw me in top lane. We may get this Ricky at the cost of a Magnus. May even this Clockwork and the Scarath, they're both out of position here. One of my Meepos is dropping fairly low. Am I going to be able to get him out? He's earned up. He doesn't look in great shape. No, I'm going to die again. So you see 0-2-1 this game. Yeah, we got the Ricky, I got an assist. Sand King looks like he might clean up here quite nicely. Clockwork's fairly low, he's not going to take that on though. But yeah, like at the start of this game, if you were to watch this, you'd probably be like, yeah, you're making these mistakes, this is not good. Like, looking back, there's various mistakes that I've been making. I could have pulled that Meepo out a lot earlier. But in the heat of the game, like I've said, it's a lot harder, you know. Now I'm sitting here, I have complete comfort of not having to control anything, I can just commentate. But when you're in the game, it's a lot different. Everyone should realize that. Whenever you criticize someone you're watching, it's a lot harder to be in the game doing that live rather than on a backseat, comfortable with nothing to control. But anyway, this game, like a lot of the Meepo games I play, doesn't get off to a fantastic start. And that's one of the things you got to realize with Meepo is, at the start, it's either going to get out of control pretty quickly and you won't end up getting a full build, you'll end up doing pretty well and then ending the game about 30 minutes, or it can scale very slowly but very nicely. Like here I get a kill there, pretty nice. This Ricky's gonna run into the range of a sentry? No, he's not. But like now we've got these two meepers at level 8, which is really nice. I got a max poof now, cogging in Clockwork, poof, so much damage. I didn't actually tell you guys about my skill build that I've been doing lately. It's actually poof at 1, hold my skill at level 2. As soon as I get level 3, that's when I take my ultimate, and that then allows me to skill poof again. So I have a level 2 poof and my ultimate. So both my Meepos have a level 2 boost, which is really nice. I would honestly recommend that if you're not looking to kill people, you're just looking to farm. We're going to catch this Doom out now. The Invoker is going to drop, but we do catch the Doom, which is really nice. A nice skewer there from what I can... obviously, like I've said, the guy I'm pre-made with. There are some nice plays in this game. A lot of action at this part in the game does happen in the bot lane, which tends to happen when you just bring both your Meepos. Or, like, you just group up like this. It's... Oh, Viking getting away really low there. The Clockwork Rocket does get a double kill. Wow, what a nice double kill. I do get cogged in here. I am going to fall. So, again, another death. Yes, I do have two kills, but they are getting off. Even though the score is fairly even, the fact that they've killed me three times is really nice for them. You really have to punish a Meepo like this. I was overextended there. The Clockwork Cook was very nice. And the Clockwork Rocket obviously was even nicer. But yeah, like you're seeing, guys, 3 deaths at 10 minutes on a Meepo is not where you want to be. Like, you can afford to not have amazing farm, but you can't really afford to die. Because when you're dead, you're not getting XP, and XP is what you need. So the Clockwork, then again, they are overextended. This is sort of like pushing back and forth, overextending, like we're both overextending, which is what you will see a lot in pub games. It's fairly bad plays. You won't see that much in pro games. You'll see odd people overextending, but not whole teams like we are here. Like, we're overextending now a bit, I feel, but their team aren't in position really to punish it. I do get a nice net there, but the Ricky Cloud, very well placed, does cut Meat and Invoker off. We can't pursue through that because the miss chance at slow on that is just insane. Not to mention the silence, obviously. Obviously, he's just gone in range of a sentry. He doesn't realize it's a nice little net. Double poof. Does blink strike out. That's a very nice blink strike. Did save his life there. If only my team were a little bit closer there, we would have got him. But you can't blame them for not being there. They weren't anticipating him. We're a little bit nervous here. We know we're overextended. Another Doom. A questionable Doom, really. These Dooms haven't been that great. But yeah. Wiping waited in there to try and get an RP. A nice silence from the Scarab does cancel that. Zeus ult does bring him down. And again, we're overextended. We're overextended again. Which is what, you know, you look back at it, it's like, oh, this is awful. These guys are just so overextended. But this is what happens in pub games. If you just all go to one lane. You're not coordinated. You're not on team speak. You're not all talking to each other. You can't tell each other to back quickly. You know, people don't listen or whatever. But they don't punish us too hard. They take two at the cost of one. It's a very back and forth game at the moment. Like with a lot of the Meepo games I play, it from the get-go, it doesn't look like I'm out to make an amazing game. And that's why I like this game, because I don't get super fed. It's not like, oh, I get really fed. I just get a load of items and just stomp them. It's like concise plays and decisions that I make lead to me having this amazing score and this full build. It's not from the get-go an amazing game, which I really like about this game. You don't know I'm gonna, you know, completely stomp them from the get-go. I'm gonna poof my obviously Meepo's in, but I can't pursue. He's out range of the tower. Ricky's smoke card is very nice skill. He's just placing that very nicely. So anyway, just looking for farm. I tend to play Meepo quite like this. A lot of people don't like the way I do this. I don't super farm with him. Like, a lot of people now would be very close to their Aghanims. I'm not. I tend to fight with him. I tend to get as much XP as I can. I tend to get really greedy, soak up all the XP, and just out-level. Because the quicker you get the Meepos, you can just accelerate your farm. You don't need to be having them sit in the jungle. Ricky's not that farmed at the moment, so he's not doing a lot of damage to me, even with the backstab. But yeah, like I said, I don't play him as a farmer. I don't just Bryce all game. I go super aggressive, fight once I get my ultimate, which I really like. That nice net that does cut him off. Wiken is going to drop here, though. He's not much he could really do that. I'm going to get a net on the Doom. I only managed to catch the Doom, which is not that great, but Jira Strike bring him down. See, level 10, you have 3 Meepos. It's so nice. It's just such an advantage. Clockwork is going to cog himself in there, but he doesn't have a TP scroll. I'm gonna just keep netting so he can't cast it or cast his battery assault, so he just gets brought down. Nice little double kill for me. This is why I like to play Meepo as an aggressive sort of carry if you can. He's versatile in that respect. You can either have him as strictly the ricer, which if you don't know that term, basically just means farming and farming and farming. Not fighting, just completely avoiding all fights and just farming. I do detect the Scarif here. I know he's around here somewhere. So does Invoker. We are going to scout him out. Nice Mystic Flare there, but he is going to get caught out. He doesn't have much to do now. He's just going to get poofed down, clicked down, no armor. He's dead. So, nice little pick there. He shouldn't really have been there, but it was good play by us to know that he was sort of there. We didn't have any vision on him. We just suspected it. So, yeah. Game is picking up now. Getting those levels. Nearly got my Aghanim Scepter. Like, this would be the same sort of speed I would be getting the Aghanim Scepter if I was just sat top farming. Which is one of the reasons I'd like to play him as an aggressive carry, aggressive mid-game carry, rather than, you know, your hard carry farmer. It's debatable. It's very debatable, actually. A lot of people will argue that he's better suited to just farming. And in some situations he is. He really can be. If the enemy team was a lot more coordinated, they have a very nice aggressive lineup here. They're just... But so do we. We're very good at punishing that. With a few nice plays, we can do a lot. Ricky's going to try and catch me out here. I'm going to bring the second two Meepos in. I'm going to net him out. The nets do reveal, which a lot of people don't actually know. Geostrike is going to take it. No, nice dust there from the Sand King. Does bring him down. So, that's the difficulty of going on a Meepo with like a Klinks or a Ricky. Two or three more are going to appear to ruin your day. So, that's what I do like about Meepo. You know, if you sounce the first one, that doesn't matter. The other three or four or two are going to come in and ruin your day, so it's nice in that respect. Well, I'm going to buy out my Aghanim Scepter here. 16 minutes, respectable time, considering my start. Mainly due to the amount of kills I was getting. Amount of gold and XP I was soaking up. Does help a lot. Doom is going to go extended here a little bit for the Invoker. Don't know what he's planning. He's just going to die. He's going to get the Invoker for it, but yeah. Not sure if that was worth it. Doom plays fairly questionably this game. I mean, I can sort of see it now. People are going to be watching this and thinking, oh, these guys are bad. This was a ranked game. Like, these people are supposed to be of the same sort of level as us. I mean, the MMR system, of course, not perfect in any respect. A lot of people complain about it. But these guys aren't bad. Like, they are making okay decisions. It's just we're punishing them like this. I'm punishing this Clockwork for being there. There's not much you can do. I'm just netting, and the Geostrike is sticking them down. The Zeus is actually fairly farmed here. Does have a fair bit. Yeah, he's got his Arcane Boots Blink. It's actually not as farmed as I thought he was. But the Blink pickup is actually quite nice for some Meepo. If you're playing versus Meepo, I would recommend mobility items over a lot of things. These guys are actually scared of me a bit now. Four Meepos are already level 15. It's just so nice. 17 minutes, people just don't expect it. Doom is going to get caught out here. Loads of poos go down. The damage is catastrophic. The mech does come out and the Scorched Earth is ticking him up, but the Geostrike is ticking him down even further. There's nothing he could do there. He was just caught out. Oh, one of my Meepos is low. Am I going to retreat him? Do retreat him a little bit late, but I do get him out in the end. Gonna micro him back there. Gonna bring in these third Meepos to try and get in on this Ricky kill. Net does land. I'm gonna send that other Meepo back. Yeah, it's weird watching myself back the way I play, but you do panic a lot when you're playing Meepo. Even me, after 250 games of him, I still panic when I blame. It does blink away from the Tornado. That was nice. We're gonna take the mid tower now, and it's hard to understand what's going wrong for the Radiant. Like, it's still only 18 to 23. They had 3 kills on me. It's just they're not coordinated, which is what Meepo is very good at exploiting. If the enemy team aren't coordinated, a lot of heroes can do it, but I feel Meepo does it very well. Because it's like, oh, someone's out of position. Blink, net, like you're seeing here. Blink, net, poof, poof, poof. I am going to get caught out of here. I am actually the one out of position here. Am I going to be able to get two? I'm going to look for two. The Doom is not gonna go down. No, it didn't go down. So yeah, me getting a little bit greedy there, seeing the Scarif, knowing how squishy he is. I thought I could take him, but I did make a misplay on those poofs. I didn't do them quick enough. Nice little... Oh, the Ricky... the Ricky ruins it for the clockwork. Oh no, that was bad. But again, we're getting caught out of position here. Very typical of pub games. The Sand King is going to punish this Ricky though. Like, the other two teammates of Ricky weren't behind him. They still could have taken that if they were a little bit more coordinated, but obviously you don't know what's behind those trees. We still had three guys up, so the Sand King coming in, punishing them. RP is going to sort of go off. Going to try and kill this Doombreaker, but he's very tanky when they don't have the physical damage that I put out. The Scorched Earth's ticking up way too hard. They're not going to get him. You know, the RP not being used that effectively, but you know, you can't take into account the mech and the Scorched Earth. So the Doom is going to drop there. Fairly nice kill. So we're just making these picks. They're making picks on us. But all in all, every time I kill someone, all four of my Meepos are there. Like the Scarif here is getting caught in position. Do double net. Just gonna get brought down. One thing I can say is we have really nice ward coverage, which is helping drastically. Zeus gonna get hot. Nets, poof's gonna go off. Oh, he does cancel the poofs. Very nice sounds there from Ricky. He did try and blink, but the tornado's gonna cancel it. He does get the blink straight off. Oh, they're both so low. Can I get them both? Ricky's gonna wander in range to that sentry. And he's gonna get caught by the golds. Not very nice. So yeah, not too accurate with my nets there. I could have got that double kill a lot easier. Obviously, sort of panicking. A couple of them were on cooldown. I could have done that a bit more cleaner. But everything can be done cleaner when you look at it in hindsight. So, 11-4-8. Going pretty nicely. The score does, I'm going to say now, ramp up quite nicely during this game. It's to say the least. So yeah, I'm going to talk about my build here a little bit. I haven't spoken anything about that yet. So yeah, I've got my treads, which I always like to pick up. Some people like tranquils. I like the treads. Purely because I used to like the treads even before the nerf, I'm going to say. Well, it was a nerf, actually. He doesn't get stat share until he gets his Aghanims anymore. It's 0%. So you could buy... You could go first item, butterfly, and your Meepos would get no benefit from that agility at all. First item heart, they would get no benefit. They wouldn't get any strength from that heart. So that's pretty bad. Like, it's quite the nerf. It did bring him down quite before this small buff. So yeah, the treads, however, because this is an item that they all share, they all get the treads, they will all get the strength. And I tend to leave them on strength. Some people switch them to agility to farm. I do that sometimes, but I tend to just leave them on strength for safety's sake and one less thing to manage. I could go out of my way to micro them and put them on int to poof and agility to do more damage, but I tend to just leave that out to so I can put my attention on other things. So I'm gonna do Roshan here. I always do Roshan once I get a Vlads. As soon as I get a Vlads, I'll do Roshan, and this is why I like to pick up the Vlads very early. It gives your Meepos, all of your Meepos, quite a lot of nice armor. It gives them aura armor, aura damage, which is just brilliant, and aura lifesteal, which is one of the main components to why I like this. It sort of just keeps them topped up a little bit, makes you harder to kill, and you obviously just do more damage. It's just a very cost-efficient item for me, but very cost-efficient. And the Bassy, obviously, I pick up fairly early. Nice aura mana, which is very useful, and aura armor, which is good for pushing. So I always tend to pick up the Bassy, and a lot of people recommend the Bassy because Meepo is very good at pushing. I'm gonna blink here, try and get this clockwork. He keeps cogging like that, and I don't think that's necessarily to his advantage. I am gonna get doomed out here. Questionable doom, really. I would never really use doom on a Meepo. It's pointless. But I am gonna get brought down very quickly here. Gonna keep looking though. I'm gonna keep poking. Gonna blink in. I do get the Scarif. Nice nets there. The Mystic Blade does absolutely no damage on 5 Meepos with that magic resistance. Gonna... Oh, the disruption does cancel the net out there. But I'm gonna look for 2 here. I do manage to net the Ricky. Is he gonna blink strike out? He is gonna try to. The Geo Strike's gonna get him. Just see how he melts with that Geo Strike in the Vlads. Net's gonna go off here. Yule set a very nice pickup from Zeus there. Does cancel me out. But the Poofs are ready on the way down. Rampage from me. Poof's ready on the way down. He's decimated. That Doom just drops as well to the Geo Strike and Vlad. So that's a free rampage for me there. could have made it a double rampage if I'd have pursued that clockwork out, but I decided to make the safe bet and not go for that. If I'd been Ultraman mode, you know, if I'd have just gone full Russian, I would have gone for that guy, but not this time, not this time. There's plenty more where that came from, guys. So obviously I did use the Aegis for that rampage. A lot of rampages I get are due to having an Aegis, but I do rampages without Aegis, guys. Don't worry about that. I'm gonna go ultra greed mode here. The Scarif, I just punished the Scarif. I am so mean to the Scarif. I get him again and I sacrifice myself in. 773 gold to Ricky. Not a good trade for me. That was super stupid. I'm just being so mean to the support Skyrim. Doesn't pay off. RP used on this Ricky here, but his teammates are there to back him up. The mech is used. He is dusted, but they're going to pursue. Nice tornado there from the Evoker. Stops the pursuit. Magnus going to be bottling up. He's got the blink. He's got the four staff. Very slippery. Very hard to get hold of. Very nice item choices there from Wyken. I like that a lot. So they can't really pick. There's a lot of sort of, in this game, you'll especially see it, a lot of item choices on both sides make it very hard for teams to kill each other. I really like force staff. You see various teams, and especially at my level now, you see people using force staff on each other, which is incredibly strong. You'll see teams like Alliance using it to great effect. Force staff is an incredible item, and it's very good versus Meepo. Incredibly good versus Meepo because he's all melee. And he's very reliant on keeping you in one place, getting the nets down, getting the poofs down. Force staff, incredible item. Yule Sept, incredible item versus Meepo. And you see a lot of these pickups on the enemy team. They do try to deal with me, but unfortunately they don't quite manage it in this game. Obviously my camera angle's a little bit off here because I've got it on play perspective. I'm just sort of, again, playing my own sort of thing. Two people are going to get picked off here, Playmate and... So the Shadow Demon and the Sand King here are going to pop off, but I'm going to punish the little overextend here. Clockwork again getting singled out. I don't know why he keeps cogging there. I guess he doesn't want all the Meepers going on him. I guess it's a good move. Going to bring him down. Going to look for this Scarif now. Do get a net on the Zeus. Poofs up going down. He's going to drop to those poofs. Nothing he can do there. I do let the Scarif escape there. Going to look for a net. Long range net on that Doom. Very nice net indeed. Going to do another one. Can I get hold of him? Ah, the net misplays. I'll get off pick today. But the Ricky's going on me. Not a great move. I'm not in the silence. Gonna get net, gonna get revealed. Ricky does drop. So does the Doom. Gonna look for another rampage. Oh, very nice blink. Yule Sept is to follow. Skyrath gonna come in from Mystic Flare. Does catch out one Meepo. 666 gold goes the way of Skyrath. So again, an ultra kill. Very nearly a rampage. Does get cut short by a few missed micros. Bit of panic. Very hectic situation. A lot happening in a very short amount of time. I do die again. I let that Meepo die to that Mystic Flare. If I went up, I was in the Mystic Flare. If I went down, I was going closer to the Skyrath, closer to two towers. So I was pretty much in a dead situation. The Zeus does play very well in this game. He does do everything he can to not die to me, and he makes my life very hard when I'm trying to get these rampages. Yule Scepter, blink, force staff. Ugh. It's just like trying to hold a wet fish. It's not fun. So anyway, another buff, if you haven't seen, is the reduced respawn time. I'm going to hover over for you guys. So at level, it goes 10, 20, and 30%. Level 3 ultimate, 30% reduced respawn time, which is amazing. It's such a nice buff. It doesn't seem insane on the surface, but it is everything that Meepo needed, in my opinion. Which are no longer punished for being over-leveled. You know, I'm level 24 at 28 minutes in. I'm nearly max level. I'm nearly level 25 at 28 minutes in. That's insane. You can get ridiculous amounts of XPM with Meepo. You can be level 25 at 25, 24 minutes in, which is incredibly advantageous. And now you no longer get the disadvantage. I'm going to bait them out with this one Meepo here. I'm going to bring in a second Meepo. It's a very nice RP work for Magnus. Mystic Flag going to go down. I am doomed up. This Ricky's going to drop low to the Jira Strike. I'm caught out there. That Meepo is going to die. Am I going to get the suicide? I get the suicide. Managed to deny myself with that Doom up. Very nice. So yeah, I am going to drop there. Do deny myself. We didn't actually manage to kill any of them. A lot of misfocus there from my team. Unfortunately, bit of a misplay from me. Those cogs really cutting me out. I didn't get the full poof queue up there. The silence going down, so a lot of crowd control being placed on me there. I couldn't really do a whole lot, but it is nice to get that suicide. I do believe I got a suicide earlier, On the first time I was doomed, I think that was with Aegis. I'm not sure. I do think, do recall getting two suicides in this game. If you didn't realise that, guys, if you're Venomancer altered, Queen of Pain, Shadow Strike, like anything that's deniable, basically, you can deny with the other Meepos, and it counts as a suicide, which is really nice. And if you can do that, I very much recommend it. It's, you know, in the heat of the moment, it's very hard to sort of remember that and micro that. But I do manage it in this game, and it's something that comes with confidence and comes with practice. So I'm gonna look for this Ricky. Oh, the miss! He does miss in the cloud. He's gonna find him. Ricky just needs to go straight now. Sunstrike, very nicely played. The Ricky does try and avoid it. Avoids the Sunstrike, but gets Burrow Strikes. So avoid one strike for another. Anyway, so now looking at 21 kills, my farm still not insane. I still don't have this. I don't know why he keeps dooming me. It's very strange. I mean, like, I know I'm a threat, but dooming a Meepo is very strange. You don't get much damage for it. Anyway, gonna look for the pick here. This doom is gonna drop to me. I could have looked for the clockwork there, actually. He is actually gonna get picked, I think. Yeah, he looks for the hook shot, but doesn't manage to get the cold snap, cancelling that. So again, doom, using doom on me, it's just, it to me, it doesn't seem, it's stupid. Don't doom a Meepo, guys. It's so stupid. I guess he just wants the damage, I guess. It's not going too well for them here, so yeah, I do manage to pick him off there. So again, 22-7-9, pretty nice score so far. We're already pushing for their racks. We've got them locked in here. Their farm isn't great there. Ricky's been looking for kills, not been farming much. I'm going to get caught out a little bit here. They don't make much use of these smoke clouds. You get a nice smoke cloud, that's slow, really affects the Meepos. They can't get out. You should just go straight on them once you get a nice smoke cloud on that, but I guess they're scared, the rest of my team. That's what's nice about the team comp we have now. I can just walk down a lane. I can just walk down a lane, and they can't go balls to the wall on me, because there's a Sand King and a Magnus waiting there to get like a 4 or 5 man or 3 man ultimate, which just devastates their team. So I can just walk down like this massive distraction, and they know if they go on me, if they go balls to the wall on me having like 3 melee heroes, they are just going to get decimated by the rest of my team, which is really nice once you get to this point in the game. I don't know why Invoke is there. I'm just going to take it as it is. He's probably just fooling around. He's got a blink dagger. Tornado gonna try and catch a couple of them out. I do spy out the Skywrath. You tasty squishy Skywrath. Don't manage to land in it. I'm a little bit caught out here. If they go for a hook shot, they're thinking about it. They don't quite know. I am being a bit over aggressive here. I don't actually have any teammates behind me, but they don't know that. I'm sort of playing with their mind a little bit here. Or just being stupid, however you see it. Fight gonna go on here, but I'm gonna opt for this tier 2 tower because there's nothing they can do about it. Don't manage to land a net on the Skywrath there. More poops coming in. Can I get a Skywrath here? Gonna look for more nets. Gonna go straight on the Skywrath because he's the easiest to bring down, and he puts out a huge amount of damage. But you're seeing these four staffs, this crowd. Look, another four staff. It's just brilliant play. Like, you can criticize these guys all you want, but they have the item pickups to deal with me. They have the Yule Scepters, the Blinks, the Four Staffs, all incredibly good versus a fed Meepo. Like, so many things are good versus Meepo, but you can eliminate so many of them if you're a good Meepo player. But one thing you can't really eliminate is good Four Staff plays and good crowd control usage, which these guys have in spades, and they're using it very well. So I do compliment them for that. It's making it very hard for me to get hold of them, which is what you want to do versus a Meepo. So yeah, just going to go for this Roshan again. I don't spy that double damage top. I should look there. But double damage, if you didn't know, if you have all your Meepos in range of the double damage, you select it with your first Meepo, every single Meepo gets double damage. It's insane. But I don't see that. That's probably going to get picked up by someone else, but I do pick up the Aegis. Really like the Aegis on Meepo at this point in the game, because you just walk at them, and there's not much they can do. So yeah. Going pretty well, 22 kills, pretty nice score, not too insane though. I'm going to try and ramp it up a little bit. This game kind of gets milked a little bit, but they do put up a very nice defense against our team. Skywrath going to get caught out there. I do try and get the kill there. I'm very mean to this Skywrath during this game. Yeah, a little bit of dewarding because they let a gem slip for whatever reason. Gonna put all the meepos in here and do a little bit of farming on this stacked ancient camp. Very nicely stacked for me. Probably by the enemy team. I'm just gonna steal it because I am meepo. All the farm is mine. So yeah, just gonna keep up the pressure now. You know, not gonna take farm where I can with my other meepos. As you can see, like, I'm not, again, even at this point in the game, I'm not sitting meepos everywhere farming. Sort of keeping them there, keeping the XP going, keeping the threat going. Pushing lanes very quickly with them. I don't like to play passive with my meepos, I like to play quite aggressive, quite brave. Which is, you know, it's arguable that that might be worse. You know, it might be bad, but it's working for me at the moment. So anyway, I'm going to keep four of my meepos pushing top, which are... It's a bit of a distraction. I'm also getting a lot of farm. I don't need any more XP, but I'm just pushing that lane. So we're pushing two lanes in at once with one hero. Gonna poof in here, gonna pick up this Scarif incredibly quick, but the Yule Scepter on him does manage to keep him alive. Again, good Yule Scepter blade does keep him alive, but I do manage to bring down the Doom now. I have taken a lot of damage for this Doom though. I still have the Aegis. Very nice blink play there from the Zeus. Blade mail here from the clockwork, but I don't care much for that. Very nice force staff. See, again, so slippery, so hard to get hold of. I'm having so much trouble keeping these guys down. They're playing so well against me, actually. And nice smoke cloud there from Ricky stops me from really doing much and getting out. But he's gonna try and go on me here. I don't think about that. Scarif's just gonna get caught out there. He shouldn't have been there on that low health. But anyway, I'm gonna retreat here after not being able to get hold of any of these slippery little suckers. Retreat here out because a lot of damage is incoming and I don't feel too confident. They are going to go on me here. Am I going to decide to go back on them? Do I get a not on Ricky? Ricky blinking in there. That's very questionable. Three of the meepers aren't in the smoke cloud, but that mischance does not work when you have five people hitting you. I do manage to take him down there with the Geostrike. Clockwork over extended here. No poof. Double kill there. Sue's coming down from the Yule Scepter. Cold snapped up. Going to keep ticking him down. Four staff again, but the Geostrike and Evoker ticking him down. He's going to die. These four staffs, so frustrating when you're a meepo player. They really are. It's just like, oh, another net to land. But anyway, I'm looking pretty fat right now. 25 kills, 7 deaths, 11 assists. Again, still not that much. Not that insane of a score. But again, treads, Aghanim Scepter, blink, heart. I always go heart on meepo, unless I'm playing versus a lifestealer. That's the only exception. And I'd like to make that very clear. Always go heart on meepo unless you're playing versus a lifesteal. Go AC, go butterfly. Butterfly is still quite nice if you play primarily with the first meepo. You bait out with the first meepo. Butterfly is very nice. It's not that bad of an item. But here I opt for the ethereal blade because ethereal blade actually gives you more agility. And agility is very nice across your other meepos. Gives them more armor, gives them more damage, gives them more attack speed. It's just nice. And the ethereal blade, I actually tend to like to use the ethereal part of it on my other meepos, especially versus a lot of physical damage. He's very tanky versus magical damage with that heart and the base magic resist he has. So the only real problem now is this Ricky, this clockwork, and this Doom, and the amount of physical damage they can put out. So the ethereal blade allows it if one of my meepos gets gone on, I need to get focused hard by some physical damage. I just ethereal blade him. And he's immune for about, I think it's 4 or 3 seconds. Ally self duration, 4 seconds. 4 seconds of physical damage immunity. It's very nice. I tend to use it quite a lot. It's also nice on the enemy team. Because meepo, at this point, starting to get quite a lot of nice agility. So I can do a lot of damage with that initial pulse from my ethereal blade, which I do use quite a lot. I'm just going to be looking for some farm here from the ancients with my other meepos. Again, I'm fairly slow when it comes to microwing for farm. That is probably my biggest weakness as meepo. I don't keep my meepo... When my meepos aren't with me, I don't keep them active enough. I tend to focus a lot on keeping myself alive. Which is not necessarily bad. It's a compensation, I guess. It's an improvement I really need to make. But there's always improvements you can make with a hero like meepo. Which is really nice. That's why I find him so interesting. You can always get better at him. But anyway, just going to push that in this lane. The empower are actually nice. You can empower every single meepo if you do it on cooldown, which is insane. And Wyken actually does do that. It's the advantage of having him pre-made here. He's just buffing up all my meepos, which is so nice. So yeah, I'm pretty much full build. But there are adjustments I can make to this build. I can sell the treads for boots of travel, which I will end up doing. poof in here. Very nice lift there, but again, the force staff and the blink getting out. The Doom is going to get caught out here. He doesn't have a force staff. The throw blade going off. Bit of a misplay of that throw blade. I shouldn't have used it there. I was clicking him down. He's going to get caught out by the tanky. Lots of damage going on. This Ricky's going to put down a smoke cloud, but I'm going to walk out of that thing. Dark clicking down this clockwork. I'm going to walk through this. Nope. Skyra's going to come up, try and get killed. The Ricky blinking on the tanky again. I'm going to get these nets out. Going to poof him up. Am I going to get him? I'm going to tick him down. Come on, he gets out so low. But this Doom getting caught out again. More nets coming up, more nets coming up. Don't even need him. Just going to tick him down with Geostrike. The slow is so insane when you have five Meepos. They're just going to keep pushing. Going to take down this Rax. Going to retreat with the low Meepos because I do have the Heart to Rask, which keeps my main Meepo nice and topped up. So I can always keep him in the field, always active. Not much damage, this physical damage isn't too bad for me. Gonna throw blade him up, gonna poof these in, he's gonna drop. Oh no, it's not. Very nice shield scepter there. Right, just bring him down on the way down. Very nice shield scepter play though. I can't really see this Ricky. I am gonna get brought down. Bit of an overextend there. They're so hard to get hold of, these guys. But yeah, again, they make a very nice defense. We do take the mid racks, which is very nice for us. We brought that down incredibly quick, obviously with a Meepo. But now I'm going to look for my next item. I honestly would recommend, guys, if you're confident with Meepo, you could be better than me at Meepo. That's entirely possible. I don't claim to be amazing at him. There are other opinions that could be just as valid, if not more valid than mine. But I would say go the Boots of Travel earlier than I do. I always look back and think I need to go Boots of Travel earlier, because the map presence you can have is insane. You can just be such a royal pain in the ass for the enemy you're playing against. You get that boost to travel, you're pushing other lanes everywhere at once. It's riskier because they can just punish you if you overextend with them, but if you're clever with the way you use them, you can do so much of boost to travel. So I do decide to pick them up as my seventh item. I would honestly recommend picking them up after your Heart of Tarrasque if you go for the Boots, Blink, Aghanim's, Heart of Tarrasque. Not in that order, you want to go Aghanim's as your first item after your Treads. Some people go before Treads, but I would recommend getting the Treads first. Anyway, go Boots of Travel earlier than I do, guys, if you're really confident with that. If you're new to Meepo, Boots of Travel is a little bit too much on your plate of micro. So I would honestly recommend not using them unless you're really ahead. But if you want to get some practice with them, go to them earlier. I would definitely recommend that. Anyway, gonna BT them in, poof them up top, and start pushing in while I push bottom, which is really nice. I feel confident enough, tanky enough now to do that. Clockwork is going to force staff himself out. Very nice force staff play. Knows I'm going to be coming in. I do spot that Zeus out. Do put a net on him there. Going to keep going for this Doom. The Doom is very easy to get hold of because he's so slow. But again, they're just kiting me around. I'm going to manage to bring down this Ricky finally after so many nets. They are going to get caught up here, but the cog splitting up my Meepos. Going to tick down that clockwork again. Going to look for another net. Can I get this Zeus on the way down? Again, one of my Meepos getting focused out, so I get a death, another death. This is like 30 kills, but no like amazing streaks anymore. They're just kiting me around, they're focusing me down. These guys are, it may look like they've played badly, but I think they're playing very well versus me. They're doing everything they can to make it as hard as possible for me to kill them, and they're doing it, and they're doing a good job of it because I'm finding it incredibly hard to kill any of them. Like, it's so hard to get hold of them. When you have no BKB, you can't get magic immunity on Meepo, which really sucks when you're melee. One of the things that keeps him balanced is the fact that you're always going to be able to get crowd controlled, especially when you're dealing with like a Ricky and that smoke cloud and the cogs, which just ruin your positioning and your hole on the game. Anyway, I buy back here, mostly out of frustration of just being kited around and not having much to do. It wasn't necessary, the respawn time reduction. It's not, my respawn isn't that big. Evoker here, gonna get caught out. Is he gonna drop? He's gonna drop. Oh, but very nice burst right there from Sankey. The Meepos coming in thick and fast. Do get a nice pick, two nice pickups there. Sorry, tripping over my words there. Two nice pickups there. Just poof, poof, poof. And just so quick with these BTs, I love it. It's 405 movement speed, which is so nice for a melee hero. A little bit of frame drop here, sorry guys, I don't know what that is. Hopefully it sorts it. There we go. But yeah, like I was saying, very nice and quick. The cogs placement, very nice, stopping me from progressing up there. And this clockwork's been placing his cogs very nicely. No, he said something else. Well, sorry for these frame drops, guys. I don't know what's happening here. But anyway, this clockwork cog placement is very nice. Oh, again, this Doom's going to get caught out. The Yule Scepter used on him there, going to keep him alive. His ears piped up. He's going to get ticked down by that Geostrike, though. Nice RP there from Wigan. Going to bring this guy down. So I'm not getting these kills. This Zeus is just so elusive, so hard to get hold of. He's playing very well. The Doom already tapping out. I still don't think they've necessarily lost this. Well, actually, we did just take four of them. I'm going to beat Caesar. I'm going to look for the Zeus. If Aerial Blade is used, I'm going to retreat out, though. Don't know what I'm doing here. I'm keeping the Meepos topped up at the back. Nice net there. Do manage to get hold of this slippery little Zeus. Going to poof in the rest of these Meepos, bring down this tasty, squishy Scarab. He's going to Yule Scepter, but I'm just going to poof them in. Bang, bang, bang. You're dead. Just queue them up as they come back down with Yule Scepter if you have time. Which I've been doing. Two buybacks used by the Radiant here. I'm still not too scared of these guys because I BT'd out one of my LO Meepos and topped them up. They're very questionable use of a Clockwork Cook. I guess he was relying heavily on that force staff, but with this Feral Blade, I can just zap them as they're getting out of there on low health. Bit of net miss micro, and I do not manage to pick up this guy. These frame drops are pretty bad. I'm sorry, guys. I have no idea what's happening here right now. But yeah, I'm gonna pick off this Scarab Ultra Kill down on these. I'm gonna look for a Rampage. Wow, this frame drop is horrific. Just gonna pause this a second. Give me a second, guys. I'm really sorry about this. I'll probably edit this out. Okay, so do pick up a second Rampage there. Very nice. Am I going to get a double Rampage? This Doom's pretty much going to feed me a double Rampage here. Quite nice. But yeah, double Rampage there. 38 kills. I am 1 from my record. I am 2 from breaking my record. Can I do it? I really hope I can. So I'm going to strive for this record. Wigan here. Well, I remember when we were on team speak, he was adamant that we were going to break this record, and he wanted to do everything in his power to help me break this record. So we're just going to do a little bit of a dick move and count this fountain in. I wouldn't normally do this, but I really want to break my record. This Zeus, I don't really think I'm going to get hold of him. He's just so hard to get hold of. Oh, my frame's dropping again. They always drop at the wrong moment. I'm going to tick down this Zeus. He does get... Wigan does sacrifice himself there for the greater good of the Meepo record. For 39 kills I need. One more to break my record. Can I do it? Zeus going to use his dual set a bit questionably here. He now doesn't have that, but he still has his four stuff. Going to redirect that ancient aggro. But the clockwork hook comes in. It is going to latch. I am going to poof back one of my Meepos back. BT one of my Meepos back to safety. Get him nice and topped up so I can keep this record going. But they are punishing this overextend. Gonna poof these Meepos out to get him a little bit top. The Scarab getting caught out. Am I gonna be able to get him? No force staff usage now. 40 kills for the Meepo. I am gonna get brought down here by the Ricky. No buyback. 40 kills. I have broken my record as my frames tank down to about 10. I am so sorry, guys. I have no idea why this is happening. Backups of 50. Life complete broke my kill record. I was very pleased when I saw that I'd broken my kill record. Can I get any more? I have 9,000 gold. 9,000. Ludicrous amounts of gold. Just so fat right now. And I didn't even have this insane start that you'd expect for a kill record like this. I'm just gobbling up all the kills. Like, it's 40-10 and 14. That's a 4 KD ratio. It's brilliant. It could have gone so much better. There's other plays I could have made. There's kills I let get away. This could have been 45, 46 kills if I'd played perfectly. But like anything, no one plays perfectly. Even pros, you're always going to be making mistakes, and that is especially true. And these guys are good sports. This Zeus, very good player. Hats off to him. Very good player. Very good mindset. I'm really sorry about these frame drops, guys. I truly am. I have no idea why this is happening. But yeah, like, very good sports, very good players. Even with the trash talk at the start of the game, it's all good. I don't mind. And this Ricky knows that Invoker is there and he really wants to kill him. But yeah, I'm back in the fray now. Gonna come back for more. I'm hungry. I want more kills. I want more record. But no, they've all retreated. They don't want to give any more kills. Let's not give this Meepo any more kills. But it's Doom. A little bit overextended here. Clockwork, they're gonna... Where did I go? Oh, I know what happened here. If you didn't know, guys, there's a respawn bug with Meepo when your second Meepo... your four Meepos that aren't your first Meepo respawn 2 seconds before your first one, which is what happened there, and I teleported back when my first Meepo respawned. Anyway, gonna get caught out here. Can I get... They're so elusive, so hard to get hold of. No poops can happen. I do manage to pick up the Sky with 41 kills. Can I get this, Ricky? Get picked off again. They focus me so hard. 41, 11, 14, the final score for this incredible game. Few well plays. Like, these guys were just great sports. Thank you very much. If any of my opponents were watching, I sincerely doubt it, but I really want to thank these guys for the amazing game they give me. They played well, and they didn't, you know, you could say whatever you want. I don't think they played badly. I don't think they fed me. I think both sides just played very well. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching this game. A lot of apologies for those frame drops. I really do apologize. I'll try and edit it out as best as possible, but there still will be those frame drops at those key moments. I do believe there were 3 rampages in that game, so quite a jam-packed game. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Thank you very much for supporting the channel. If you enjoyed that video, or if you are looking to follow someone who plays Meepo regularly, and want to see more Meepo gameplay videos and more guides, whatever, on Meepo, it's very much focused on Meepo, do remember to subscribe, follow, all that good stuff. I will link my Twitch and my Twitter in the description below. Obviously, I know a lot of people don't like all these social networking sites, but it's a great way to know when I go live and when I'm broadcasting. It's a great way to follow me and keep up with what I'm doing if you're at all interested. If you're not interested, I respect that. Please let me know what you thought of this video. Obviously, the frame drops were a big issue. I really apologize for that. I'm going to try and find out what happened there. But give me some constructive criticism, guys. I really appreciate it. I don't get offended at all. So tell me what you think. Remember to comment. Like if you'd liked it, because it helps me obviously get more exposure, which is really helpful. And if you're at all interested in watching me play live, follow me on Twitch. So sorry for rambling a little bit, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Keep in touch and keep playing Dota, because that's the main thing. Keep playing Dota. Goodbye, guys.